Welcome to ATCM, the Emergency Medicine Channel. Today,
let us discuss about alcohol withdrawal state and its management in emergency room. Alcohol use is a global concern. It ranking 7th among the leading cause for death and disability. There are a lot of illnesses can be produced by chronic alcoholism, like alcoholic cardiomyopathy, alcoholic myopathy, like proximal myopathy, gastritis and GI bleeds, chronic liver disease like fatty liver, cirrhosis, portal hypertension, polyneuropathy, alcohol induced pancreatitis and thiamine deficiency, which may lead to beriberi and neurological complications. Alcoholism is defined as any drinking of alcohol that results in significant mental or physical health problem. That is a definition of alcoholism. Alcoholic dependence is defined as a chronic disease in which person craves alcohol that contains a significant amount of alcohol percentage, is unable to control his habit of drinking. A person with this disease also needs to drink larger amount to get the same effect and has withdrawal symptoms after stopping alcohol use. Alcoholism can affect physical and mental health, and it can cause problem in his social life, like relation with family, friends and work. Acute alcohol withdrawal is defined as abrupt reduction or total cessation of long-term alcohol consumption produces well-defined cluster of symptoms called alcohol withdrawal state. We see what causes this problem. Gamma aminobutyric acid, this is a neurotransmitter in brain. Its highly specific binding sites for ethanol are found in GABA receptor complex. Chronic ethanol use induces an insensitivity to GABA. So there is a problem due to chronic ethanol use. So their levels will be high in the brain in chronic alcohol abuse. Cessation of alcohol or reduction from the chronically elevated concentration result in decreased inhibitory tone. So they will become hyperactive. And there is a problem in alcohol withdrawal state. We will see what are the criteria to diagnose alcohol withdrawal state. Criteria 1 is stoppage or reduction of alcohol intake, which was there for a long time and the quantity was very high. Criteria 2 is two or more of the following symptoms have developed within hours to few days after criterion 1. Autonomic hyperactivity, increased hand tremors, it's mainly fine tremors, insomnia, no sleep, transient visual, tactile, auditory hallucinations or illusions, nausea or vomiting, excessive purposeless physical activity, anxiety and seizures, that is generalized seizures. Criteria 3 is the symptom in criterion 2 causes clinically significant distress or impairment in social, occupational or other important areas of functioning. Criterion 4 is the symptoms are not attributable to general medical condition and are not better accounted for by any other mental disorder. So, is not related to any other psychological or psychiatric disorder. So, these are the criterion to make a diagnosis of alcohol withdrawal state. Now we'll see the risk factors for developing withdrawal state. A history of sustained drinking for many days, past history of alcohol withdrawal seizures or delirium tremens. We'll see what is that. Age more than 30, presence of concurrent illness, any other illness like any concurrent fever or diabetes, all these things. The presence of significant alcohol withdrawal in the presence of an elevated blood alcohol concentration. Even high levels of alcohol itself, patient can develop alcohol withdrawal state because they may be on a larger amount of alcohol previously. Now the amount has come down, but even it is not completely stopped. A longer period since the last drink, that also can produce alcohol withdrawal state. Now many patients can develop with severe seizures, status epilepticus. They are mainly generalized seizures, grand mal seizures. Sometimes spasmodic muscle contractions can also present. They normally present locally and become generalized problem. Seizures usually occur within 12 to 48 hours after the last alcoholic drink, but it can also present the first few hours of alcohol withdrawal. There are a lot of differential diagnoses for seizures in an alcoholic patient. Other than the withdrawal state, it can be due to hypoglycemia, severe hypoglycemia. It can be due to previous head trauma and bleed, intracranial bleeds. So we have to differentiate between alcohol withdrawal seizure and other causes for seizures. So sometimes we need to take CT or MRI to rule out bleeding. Blood sugar should be tested in emergency room itself to rule out hypoglycemia. So all these things are possible, but withdrawal seizures are classically occurring within 12 to 48 hours and they start on one side and later becomes generalized. Normally they are grand mal seizures or generalized tonic-clonic seizures. We'll see what is delirium tremens. They are serious manifestation of alcoholic dependence that develops 48 hours after the onset of acute alcohol withdrawal state in persons who have been drinking excessively for years. So they are called as delirium tremens. They are tremens. These delirium tremens are characterized by visual hallucination, profound confusion, tachycardia, hypertension, hyperthermia, agitation, and diaphoresis. Signs of delirium tremens are due to extreme hyperactivity of autonomic nervous system along with hallucinations. So, delirium tremens are classically occurring during alcohol withdrawal state. So, that should be effectively treated. They are mainly due to autonomic dysfunction. Now, many patients can also have complication because of alcoholism like Wernicke-Korsakoff psychosis or Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. So, it's a syndrome. Syndrome means there are a lot of parts of this disease should be present in that patient. But in some patients, it will be a partial syndrome. That means only few diagnoses, only few clinical findings only we'll be seeing in that particular patient. So we'll see what are the features of Wernicke's and Korsakoff psychosis. Korsakoff psychosis is impaired ability to learn and confabulation and retrograde amnesia. In that, most important feature is confabulation. Patient unconsciously fabricate imaginary or confused accounts of events they cannot recall. So, they try to fill the gaps of memory with new stories. That is confabulation. That is a classical finding seen in Korsakoff psychosis. So they have impaired ability to learn. They fill the gaps in memory with new stories, and retrograde amnesia also can be seen. These are the classical findings you see in Korsakoff psychosis. It's a part of beriberi. It's due to thiamine deficiency, and especially in the nervous system. Another finding what we see in thiamine deficiency is Wernicke's encephalopathy. There is a classical triad for this encephalopathy. You can see all these three findings in some patients. Some patients you can see only partial finding. They are ophthalmoplegia, ataxia, and disorientation. Oculomotor abnormalities include horizontal nystagmus on lateral gaze, lateral rectus palsy, there is bilateral lateral LR6, lateral rectal palsy, 6 renal nerve may be involved there, conjugate gaze palsies, and rarely ptosis. Pupils are usually spared. Gait ataxia probably result from combination of polyneuropathy, cerebellar involvement, and vestibular paralysis. So these patients can have ophthalmoplegia, gaze palsies, nystagmus, ataxia, and disorientation. So patient who is having alcoholic withdrawal state can also have this type of finding. They can coexist. So this thiamine deficiency induced beriberi can be a part of alcohol induced beriberi. So that also will be there in some patients. So we have discussed about Wernicke's encephalopathy and Korsakoff psychosis. This will be a clinical picture resembling Wernicke's encephalopathy. So remember, ophthalmoplegia, disorientation, and unable to walk. Many patients can have decreased tendon reflexes. That is mainly maybe due to peripheral neuropathy. All these things findings can be seen in chronic alcoholism. Now, when we manage delirium tremens or alcohol withdrawal state, we have to keep in mind that we have to treat the hallucination, we have to treat seizure, we have to treat thiamine deficiency, we have to correct hypoglycemia. So we have to start anti-seizure medication, thiamine infusion, then dextrose infusion, and other supportive medication. Some patients may require mechanical ventilation, some patients may require oral airways, some patients may require clearing of oral secretions. All these things are required in patients. Dexmedetomidine is a sedative and analgesic medicine that is frequently used in patients who is having agitation in emergency room in chronic alcoholism, because many patients will have severe liver damage where we may not be able to use sedatives. So this will be an ideal drug. But other patients, we can go for diazepamidol, that we will discuss. Now, before starting any treatment in chronic alcoholic patient, remember we must treat this patient with thiamine. Thiamine replacement is very, very important, because many of these patients will have severe thiamine deficiency. Since they have agitation and altered behavior, we may not be able to fully diagnose thiamine deficiency clinically. So thiamine injection should be started as 500 milligram IM or IV, 3 times we can give. So that should be given initially itself. Even if we don't find thiamine deficiency clinically, we must treat these patients with IV thiamine. Then thiamine can be continued 75 milligram once per day. So all patients who is having alcohol, chronic alcohol intake, or alcohol withdrawal state, or alcohol induced acute delirium, we have to treat the patient with thiamine. Even in hyperemesis gravidarum, in pregnancy also, patient should be treated with thiamine to avoid beriberi. So thiamine should be given first, then only we should give dextrose. If we give dextrose first and if we don't give thiamine, then it can lead to severe thiamine deficiency that can aggravate the problem in thiamine deficiency. Now in delirium tremens, the most important treatment is benzodiazepine. We can give diazepam or lorazepam. The dose is diazepam 5 to 10 milligram IV, lorazepam 2 to 4 milligram IV. Many patients who are agitated may require chlordiazepoxide, that is Librium. You can give chlordiazepoxide 10 to 25 milligram slowly. That also can be given. Some patients may require phenobarbital 130 to 260 milligram IV can be given. It can be repeated after 15 to 20 minutes. So these are the drugs which can control delirium tremens. They are mainly due to autonomic dysfunction. Etcamprosate is another drug which should be used in patients who are dependent on alcohol. They are indicated in patients who are in alcohol abstinence and they have a carving nature for alcohol. So they can be used in alcohol withdrawal. They are not a drug of choice in alcohol withdrawal. Acutely you have to treat with benzodiazepine, phenobarbital or drugs which can calm down the patient. But this should be continued. The patient dose is 666 milligram per oral TID. 666 milligram per oral TID is the dose. Another drug is disulfiram. They can be used in chronic alcoholism, alcohol dependence. So dose is 500 milligram daily, given in a single dose for 1 to 2 weeks. Then average maintenance dose is 250 milligram daily. So remember, patient should be counseled properly and patient should never take alcohol along with disulfiram. If they take alcohol along with disulfiram, patient will present with severe vomiting, sweating, chest pain, tachycardia, palpitation, breathlessness, hyperventilation, hypotension, syncopal attacks. All these things can develop in a patient who is having patient is taking disulfiram and they take alcohol on top of this. So they also present like this disulfiram reaction can present like delirium tremens or alcohol withdrawal state. So we should be very careful when we are treating patients with disulfiram. We have to counsel properly before giving this drug and counsel the patient not to have alcohol. So without patient's knowledge, you should never start disulfiram. So, if they take disulfiram and alcohol together, they can present with all these complications. Now, baclofen also tried by many physicians. Trials of baclofen were done in critically ill patients. They have varying type of results. At present, they are not indicated, but still trials are going on in alcohol withdrawal state.
Thank you.